Hey guys, welcome back to the next video. If you're new to the channel, welcome. This is Richard from WELSHYTECH, and today we have the coolermaster v4 alpha 3d hp cpu cooler. Looks like an engine. Okay then, so today what we've got is the v4 alpha 3d hp black. Now this is coolermaster's brand new coolers, one of them. And there's all the specs for there. So what we'll do first was have a look at the accessories. So it comes with all the information you need. Then of course, then it comes with the manual. But here, this will tell you how to install it with AMD as well as Intel. It's warranty, a little bit of packing foam or super dry there. Okay, so then we've got the mounting brackets for AMD and Intel. But there we've got an extension cable, which is quite cool. That's nice to have. Right. And then we got the cooler itself. So what we'll do now is I'll pull the cooler out and we'll have a look. Okay, so let's open this up. Now, yes, first thing you're going to notice is this looks like an engine block. One of the main reasons why I wanted to do coverage of this, because of the overall look. Now, this, of course, is probably the lower end one of the V line. They've got another one as well. I think it's the V6 and then the V8. The V8, the big one. Now, look at that. That is gorgeous. I love the overall look and the style. Now, with these chambers by here, now there's some sort of a 3D pipe in the middle. They did showcase this Computex. So what we'll do now is I'll give you some of the specs of it and so forth. So CPU socket to support, it is Intel LGA 1851, 1700, 1200, 1151, 1150, 1155, and 1156. 1156 would be back down to, that would be the, I believe it's the Sandy Bridge and that era, or it might be just before that. The AM4 and AM5 it does support. Now, as for the overall dimensions, it's 133 by 114 by 161 millimeters. That would be the height of the cooler itself. Now, the heatsink material, it's got two 3D heat pipes in the middle, and then it's got obviously these by here, then of course got aluminium fins. Now as for the fans, the first fan would be the front one, so that would be this one by here. This one's a 120 by 120 by 25. It's non-LED, it's got a zero between 0 and 2050 rpm. The airflow max is 63.1 CFM with an air pressure max at 2.69 millimeter H2O. The MTTF is 200,000 hours. The noise decibel is 22.6 dB. The bearings are loop dynamic bearings. It's got a 4-pin PWM connector. Fantastic. The rated voltage is 12 volt DC. It's got a 0.12 amp. That's for the rated current. The safety current is 0.35 amp with a power consumption. This is for this fan, 1.44 watts, and it's got a 5-year warranty. Now, the second fan is basically, this one is the same size or the same dimensions, but the speeds are different, as well as the airflow and the air pressure. So for the airflow, this one is only at 50.5 CFM, and then the air pressure is 1.77 millimeter H2O. This has 200,000 hour rated as well, with a 20 decibel rating. This has a loop dynamic bearing as well. The rated voltage is 12 volt DC. It's got a rated current at 0.08 with a safety current 0.35 amp with a 0.96 watt. So that's it for that. Now let's get this on the test bench and see how good this performs. Okay, so as for the installation, now you're going to need these two screws and you're going to need the mounting brackets for AMD specifically. Now obviously this is how you do it. The comes with two screws. These are the ones for the AMD, and then it's going to be one separate then for Intel. So I'm going to show you how to put these on the cooler. So what you want to do is take one side. Now it only goes in one direction, just like that. Okay, so what you want to do is put it there, place it that way. As you can see, the curvature goes out. You want to put it like that. Now, if I do screw it in a little, grab a magnetic screwdriver, screw it in, and that's one side. Now, let's repeat the process. Now, same thing, but this time it's going to be a bit quicker. So, place the brackets there, screw in. Magnetic screwdriver is definitely going to help a bit, much better, so... Now, it's going to bottom out, and that's it for the bracket. Now, as for installing the cooler, we'll get to that. First of all, we go with a little bit of thermal paste. Now, obviously, the application is going to vary, but I'm just doing this my way, the way I do it anyway. So, I just do a line of thermal paste in the middle, and generally, the cooler will actually spread that out good. Now, as for the cooler itself, now, what I'm going to do is place it down like this. Now, you're better off making sure that the actual holes line up. So, you want to put one there, like that. Right. Now, this is the tricky part. Now, get rid of the magnet screwer. You're going to need something that's quite long. So, what you want to do is one side. So, trust me, you'll feel it when it starts to pinch the threads. And then you do it with both corners. Okay, and then just repeat the process going from that side to here to here to here, do it in a crisscross pattern so then it will evenly spread the thermal paste outwards. But quite honestly, as long as it's down, these don't actually thread all the way. They don't go that far in the bracket, which it's okay, it'll stop you from over tightening, but let's get to the fans. Now, what I'm not fond of is this design. Now, where you can see it, look, it's mounted to this shroud on top. So the only way to actually mount the fan is doing both of them at the same time. Now, this is going to get a little bit tricky, so I suggest removing your graphics card so you've got enough room for both sides. So, what you want to really do, first of all, is place both cables each side. Place this downward like this. Now, it will just slot in on grooves on top of this, under this plate, because it's already got these grooves and it's magnetic. So all you want to do then is clip that side, clip that side, clip that side, and clip that side. Now, as for the cables, these are basic 4-pin PWM. These are 4-pin PWM. Now, I'm going to show you a 4-pin PWM header. Now, unfortunately, you won't be able to see the CPU header, but one is going to be right here or near the CPU. It's going to say label on it, underneath it or above it, it'll say CPU header. So, now, that is a PWM header. That's what it looks like on your motherboard. Now, this does come with a splitter for both fans, so you can control both fans simultaneously. So, what you want to do is grab one end. Now, it's only keyed one way. As you can see, the groove in the plastic there is there. So all you want to do is go like this, press it down, and it's done. This is the coolermaster V4 Alpha at 50% fan speed. Basically silent at 50%. Same thing, but 100% fan speed. There is a little bit of a whine, but it's not loud. Okay, so when it comes to the overall testing system I used for testing, it is my AM5 platform. It's a Ryzen 9 7900. I do use PBO for these tests. It is a B650 motherboard from MSI. It does have 32 gigs of A-Pacer DDR5. It does have an RX 7800 XT Nitro Plus from Sapphire. And it does have a 1000 watt Kolink power supply. And it's also housed in the B-Choir channel base 800FX with 4 140 light wing fans. Okay, so when it comes to the room temperature, before testing, I did get it at 12 degrees, and it did go up to 17 Celsius. So, when it comes to the testing, well, same testing I always do, 50 and 100%. For 50% fan speed, the CPU power draw at high was 163, with a low at 152. The CPU clocks were high at 5.4 and a low at 5. Now, as for Cinebench R23, the idles are 34 with a max of 90. Blender Pavilion, idles 34 with a max of 90. Blender Classroom, idles 34 with a max of 89. And 3D Mark Super Test, idles 34 with a max of 80 Celsius. So, for 100% fan speed, now we did get an actual an up when it comes to the power draw. The high on the CPU power was 170 watts. And the low was 152. The CPU clocks didn't change. They were at 5.4 and 5 at low. So, as for Cinebench R23, the idles were 32 with a max of 86. Blender Pavilion, idles 32 with a max of 85. Blender Classroom, idles 32 with a max of 85. And 3D Mark CPU Test, idles 32 with a max of 77. Now, what you'll see by here is a few other coolers I have tested, particularly single tower coolers. I will add maybe one or two dual towers just so you guys can get a reference on how this performs up against one of those. But as you'll probably see from the graphs here, that this is within the range of a dual tower when it comes to like the overall thermals. Now, obviously noise is different, but still, this does perform within that region, and for the money you pay in, I think it's very good, because it does perform at one of the higher thermal outputted coolers I've tested. Okay then, so what did you think of that? Now, first of all, I'm going to give you my overall opinion, my overall thoughts on this cooler. Now, I love the design, personally, but that's because I like cars. I like the V4 style of it, because it does look like an engine cover. Now, they do have V8 as well, which I'm hoping to get those on the channel as well, just so I can have a collection. But this performs just as good as a dual tower cooler, which is kind of odd, because this basically only has two heat pipes, but it's got these pipes then in the middle that are kind of like 3D'd and stuff like that. Now look, I don't completely understand what they've done, but this performs fantastically for what it really is. This is basically a single tower with two fans, which compared to dual towers, like let's just say Thermalright, the PLS Assassin, this performs around the same as a PLS Assassin. Now yes, you can get the PLS Assassin a bit cheaper, but if you don't want RGB, which these will come with an RGB version, everyone, I guarantee it will, but if you like this overall design, this is definitely a fantastic cooler to look at. So, yeah. Now look, this gets a big thumbs up for me. I like the fact that it's designed toward more car theme. I like the overall design of it as well. I like that it does perform very well. It's a little bit loud, but that's just me. But yes, it gets my recommendation, because I really think for the money it's very, very good. And that's quite hard to say in 2025, considering how prices on like GPUs and stuff have gone up. So yeah, look, make sure you subscribe. I've got absolute tons of stuff coming. I've still got motherboards, I've got a GPU, I've just had my first ever RTX card from PNY. I've got Lee and Lee stuff here to review. I've had stuff from NMAX. I've got absolute tons of stuff from Hatta. I've got loads of stuff here to review. So make sure you subscribe. And as always, I hope you guys have a fantastic weekend or week. This is Rich for WELSHYTECH. Goodbye.